Dear students, this is our last lecture in this semester on quantum chemistry, which is based on harmonic oscillator. We will finish the derivation for harmonic oscillator and also try to solve the problems based on this. It has been a long derivation, three lectures we have took it, but today it will be finishing. We will finish this derivation by using polynomial method. And find out the Hermite polynomials and then try to solve the problems based on Hermite polynomials. In the last lecture, we had derived up to the Hermite's differential equations, that is equation number 7 is also called as Hermite's differential equation. The solution for this Hermite's differential equation could be obtained by using polynomial method and where by assuming f of y in an expanded power series in y, so that, such that f is equal to a0 plus a1y plus a2y square and so on. So we had seen it in the last lecture about the f df by dy and d square f by dy square. Now we will be using this f df by dy and d square f by dy square terms in the equation number 7, substitute them and try to solve and find out the energy values as well as the recursion formula, so that we can easily get the terms, this a0, a1, a2, a3, these coefficients we can obtain it so that the final solution can be obtained for this power series.
Now, when we substitute the values of this d square f by dy square, df by dy and f in this equation number 7, so hume iski values milegi, ye equation hume milega in the form of पर्टिकुलर पॉलिनोमियल टाइप के इक्वेशन में हमें ये मिलेगा. सो दैट वी कैन राइट इट एज फर्स्ट डी स्क्वायर एफ बाय डी वाई स्क्वायर दैट इज 1 इंटू 2 ए 2 प्लस 2 इंटू 3 ए 3 वाई प्लस 3 इंटू 4 ए 4 वाई स्क्वायर प्लस सो ऑन. ये हमारा डी स्क्वायर एफ बाय डी वाई स्क्वायर हुआ. उसके बाद था इक्वेशन 7 में हमारे पास था माइनस 2y df by dy. सो माइनस 2y को हम इसके साथ मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे df by dy को एंड देन वी विल गेट दैट इक्वेशन. सो दैट विल बी माइनस 2y मींस हमें ये सारे टर्म्स को 2 से मल्टीप्लाई करना है. सारे टर्म्स को हमें 2 से मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे सो दैट विल बी 2 into 1. यहां पे a1 का हमारे आगे में 1 है. So that we are writing it as 1 and then y से multiply करते जाना है. So a1 को y से multiply किया, then we will have 2 into 2, a2 y already है, so और एक बार y से multiply करेंगे a square, that is y square होगा, then it will be 2 into 3, we will have a3 y cube plus 3 into 4, a4, y to the power of 4, plus so on. ये हमारा y term हुआ, उसके बाद में था हमारा f term, f term was alpha upon beta minus 1 into f. तो alpha upon beta minus 1 को हमें multiply करना है सभी term से of f के. So that will be alpha upon beta minus 1 a0 plus alpha upon beta minus 1 a1 y plus alpha upon beta minus 1 minus 1, then a2 y square and so on. This will be equal to 0. Now this equation, the above equation can be satisfied because here all the three terms are equal to zero. So each of the coefficients of this must be equal to zero. Each of the sum of the coefficients must be equal to zero. Means हमारा ये जो term है पहला वाला a2 का, यहाँ पे ये y to the power of zero है. So सारे ही y to the power of zero के जितने भी coefficients है यहाँ पे 1 into 2 into a2, then second इसमें नहीं है हमारा y to the power of zero. Third इसमें हमारा y to the power of zero ये a zero वाला term है. That will be alpha upon beta minus 1 into a zero. तो ये दोनों का total हमारा जीरो आना चाहिए. वैसे ही y to the power of 1 वाले terms means ये term, then ये term हमारा रहेगा, ये भी y to the power of 1 है, ये भी हमारा y to the power of 1 है. तो ये तीनों का sum addition करेंगे तो equal to zero आना चाहिए. वैसे ही y to the power of 2, that is y square वाले terms, ये तो हमारे y square वाले terms है, इसके जो coefficients है ये coefficients का भी sum is equal to zero आना चाहिए, तभी ये टोटल जाकर के हमारा जीरो होगा. ऐसे इक्वेशंस में जहां पर हमारा पावर सीरीज होता है, पावर सीरीज में हर एक का सम ऑफ द कोएफिशिएंट्स मस्ट बी इक्वल टू जीरो, देन ओनली इक्वेशन इज टोटल इक्वल्स टू जीरो. सो ये हमें टोटल करना है जीरो, देन द अबो इक्वेशन कैन बी सेटिस्फाइड ओनली इफ द कोएफिशिएंट of each power, coefficient of each power of y is zero, of each power of y is zero, that is हमारा पहला for y to the power of zero we will have y to the power of zero वाला term ये एक है. If we have this particular term and this term we have, यहाँ पे y to the power of zero वाला term नहीं है, so ये दोनों terms का addition जो होगा हमारा, that will be 1 into 2 a2 plus alpha upon beta minus 1 a0 will be equal to zero for y to the power of 1. For y to the power of 1, we have this 2 into 3 a3 plus y term हमें यहां से निकाल देना है, because उसके coefficient सबसे देख रहे हैं. तो यहां पर हमारा होगा 2 into 1 y 2 into 1 into a1 plus this is not plus, this is minus, यहाँ पे बाहर minus है हमारा, so ये minus आएगा, यहाँ पे हमारा ये plus आएगा, so plus alpha upon beta minus 1 into a1 is equal to 0. So if we go on doing this, then we can have a generalized terms for this, like for y to the power of some constant k. For this, what we will have is, यहाँ पे जैसे आप देख रहे हो, ये जब zero है, to the power zero है, तो यहाँ पे उसका next term into उसका next. That is, अगर यहाँ पे हमारा n है, तो n plus 1 n, n into n plus 2. तो यहाँ पे अगर हमारा power k है, तो यहाँ पे होगा हमारा k plus 1 into k plus 2. Then ये zero power है तो यहाँ पे a2 आया, one power है तो यहाँ पे three आया, so यहाँ पर हमारा a k plus two आएगा, a k plus two आएगा, then we will have plus यहाँ पे ये दोनों को अगर हम करते हैं, ये दोनों ही हमारे a1 terms, so इन दोनों को अगर हम summation करते हैं, add करते हैं, तो what we will get is इन दोनों का एडिशन होकर के ये a1 से कंबाइन करेंगे तो वी विल हैव दिस एस अल्फा अपॉन बीटा माइनस 1, दिस विल बी माइनस 2, माइनस 1 इनटू माइनस 2. सो दैट वी कैन हैव इट एस here in a general term we can have as alpha upon beta minus 1. ये हमारा कांस्टेंट है. यहाँ पे ये जो है दैट इज कमिंग ओवर हियर एज ये जो हमारा टर्म है 1, वो 1 यहाँ पे एंड 1 प्लस 1. तो यहाँ पे हमारा k एंड k प्लस 1. सो दैट विल बी 2k वी विल बी हैविंग इट ओवर हियर. सो दिस विल बी इक्वल टू माइनस 2k इनटू ये हमारा y टू द पावर 1 है और यहाँ पे भी a 1 है. सो इट विल बी k. यहाँ पे y टू द पावर k है. सो हियर वी आर टेकिंग इट एज k. दिस शुड बी इक्वल टू 0. सो इस इक्वेशन को अगर हम सॉल्व करते हैं k सीरीज का, देन वी विल गेट दिस, वी विल गेट हियर एज k प्लस 1 इनटू k प्लस 2 a k प्लस 2 इज इक्वल टू माइनस ऑफ alpha upon beta minus 1 minus 2k into a such that we will have, if we will solve this for a k plus 2, this we will get it as minus alpha upon beta minus 1 minus 2k AK upon K plus 1 into K plus 2. This formula can be utilized for finding out the coefficient. This equation 8, where K is an integer, where K is an integer, is called recursion formula. This we call it as recursion formula. So from this, if we know a zero, from this recursion formula, and the use of this recursion formula is that if we know a zero, we can find A2, A4, A6, A8 and so on. सारे even coefficients हम यहाँ से पता कर सकते हैं. Because A0 अगर पता है तो वो हम यहाँ पे formula में डाल करके that is A0 plus 2, that is A2 हम find out कर सकते हैं. A2 को यहाँ डालेंगे तो A4 मिलेगा and so on we can get it. Similarly, if we know A1, then A3, A5, A6, and A, A7, and so on can be obtained. This can be obtained. That is, कि अगर हमारे पास A1 और A0 coefficients हो, तो हम बाकी के सारे coefficients find out कर सकते हैं इस particular power series. तो ये पावर सीरीज हमें इजीली मिल सकता है अगर हमारे पास दो कोएफिशिएंट्स हो. बाय यूजिंग दिस रिकर्शन फार्मूला वी कैन इजीली फाइंड आउट दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग. सो दिस इज द यूज ऑफ दिस रिकर्शन फार्मूला फॉर फाइंडिंग आउट दिस कोएफिशिएंट्स इन द पावर सीरीज ऑफ सॉल्यूशन फॉर द हार्मोनिक ऑसिलेटर. But in any case, this power series will consist of infinite number of terms because we will have A1, A0, A1, A2, A3 and so on up to infinite. So the function f of y will tend to infinity because we have infinite number of terms. So infinity at y, as y tends to infinity. For finite solutions, or finite values in series, for certain value of k, say n, for a certain value of k, let that k be equal to n. The numerator of recursion formula must vanish. The numerator of the recursion formula vanishes. That is alpha upon beta minus 1 minus 2k equals to 0 when k is equal to n. That is alpha upon beta minus 1 minus 2n is equal to 0. Or we will have alpha upon beta is equal to 2n plus 1, where n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. This resulting series, with finite number of terms, is a polynomial. Called as Hermite polynomial. The polynomial called as Hermite polynomial given by Hn of y. Hn of y can be given as minus 1 raised to n e to the power of y square dn by dyn e to the power of minus y square. This will be giving us the generating equation or the generating function. For finding out this particular Hermite polynomial for different values, we can just find it out the different values for this. The energy for this harmonic oscillator, satisfactory wave functions we have obtained, but the energy for this can be obtained from the equation. This particular relation, that is energy of harmonic oscillator. We are more interested in the energy can be obtained by alpha upon beta is equal to 2n plus 1. What is alpha? And what is beta? Way back in some ages that we had defined this alpha and beta, where alpha is equal to, humne kuch saal pehle alpha ko define kiya tha na, jab humne ye harmonic oscillator start kiya tha tab humne alpha ko define kiya tha. That is alpha is equal to 8 pi square m e, if you remember it. या फिर आपने लिखा होगा तो ये आपके वहां पर मिल जाएगा. एंड बीटा इज इक्वल टू 4 पाई स्क्वायर न्यू एम अपॉन एच. तो ये हमें अल्फा और बीटा को देंगे. सो अल्फा एंड बीटा वी कैन हैव इट फ्रॉम हियर. सो व्हाट वी कैन गेट इज दिस पर्टिकुलर इक्वेशन में अगर हम उसका वैल्यू निकालते हैं तो अल्फा इज 8 पाई स्क्वायर एम ई अपॉन बीटा दैट इज एच स्क्वायर इनटू बीटा का हम उल्टा करेंगे 1 अपॉन बीटा है तो एच अपॉन 4 पाई स्क्वायर म्यू एम इक्वल्स 2 एम एच स्क्वायर. What we have done is we have just reciprocated this beta that we have got it here. So यहाँ पे अगर हम terms cancel करें तो pi square gets cancelled, m and m gets cancelled. एक h नीचे से जाएगा denominator से और h numerator का जाएगा. And we have this 1, 4 ones up and 4 twos. So this remains with 2e upon nu equals 2n plus 1. 2e upon nu is equal to, h भी एक रहेगा यहाँ पे, यहाँ पे एक h रहेगा, एक लग गया. So 2e upon h nu is equal to 2n plus 1. That is, we will have e is equal to half into 2n plus 1 h nu. Or we can have this as n plus half. अगर ये half को अंदर लेंगे तो two एक n का two cut हो जाएगा यहाँ पे half बचेगा n plus half h nu. If you remember this equation, we had this equation for vibrations, vibrational spectroscopy में जो energy levels हैं उसके लिए हमने ये equation derive किया. For n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on, such that for n is equal to 0, we will have e is equal to half h mu, n is equal to 1, e1 will be equal to 1 plus half 3 by 2 h mu, n is equal to 2, e2 will be 5 by 2 h mu. So it will be, this will be our E0, E1, E2. So all will be equally spaced lines. This is a harmonic oscillator or vibrational spectrum. This shows that number one, energy is quantized. This was our real problem. So in real problem also, we are getting energy is quantized for harmonic oscillator and not a continuous like what it was expected by the classical mechanics. So that one thing we get it from here. The second is the lowest energy is not zero. Lowest energy called zero point energy has some finite value. Has finite value and not zero. That is E0 is equal to half h nu. So even if all the other motions of the molecule ceases to exist, this will be there. That is, molecule vibrate karta rahega even at -273.15 degree Kelvin, degree Celsius. 0 degree Kelvin mein bhi molecule hamara vibrate karta rahega, vibrations wahan pe chalu rahenge. And as the n increases, there will be increase in the energy. As n increases, we get equispaced or equidistant energy levels. Equidistant energy levels. Because E0 or E1 mein h nu ka difference hai, E1 se E2 mein h nu ka difference hai, E2 se E3 mein h nu ka difference hai. So that difference is constant over here. We have one problem, not more than that. Hermite polynomials are derived from generating function as Hn of y equals minus 1 to the power of n e to the power of y square dn by d yn into e to the power of minus y square. This is the generating function that is given to you in problem. It will be given where n is vibrational quantum number because we are dealing with harmonic oscillator, so it will be vibrational quantum number or vibrational motion, and also the degree of polynomial. Calculate the polynomials for n is equal to 1, n is equal to 2, and n is equal to 3. So this is your problem. So the solution for this we can have as we have Hermite polynomial as Hn of y equals minus 1 raised to n e square e to the power of y square dn by d y to the power of n e to the power of minus y square. Let this be our equation number 1. Now what we need to do is we need to substitute n is equal to 1, 2 and 3 and find out the polynomials for this. It's a simple problem. ये इक्वेशन आपको दिया गया है, इस इक्वेशन में जो n वैल्यू है वो n वैल्यू को आपको सब्स्टिट्यूट करना है एज n इज इक्वल टू 1, n इज इक्वल टू 2 एंड n इज इक्वल टू 3. सो फर्स्ट हम करेंगे फॉर n इज इक्वल टू 1. फॉर n इज इक्वल टू 1 आवर इक्वेशन विल बिकम नाउ एज अ it will be h1 of y because we are substituting n as 1. This will be minus 1 raised to 1 e to the power of y square d by dy into e to the power of minus y square. So d by dy of e to the power of minus y square. So this will be minus 1 e to the power of y square d by dy of e to the power of minus y square will be equal to minus 2 y into e to the power of minus y square. This is e to the power of minus y square. Ye bhi hamara e to the power of minus y square hai. So ये minus 2y into minus 1 will become plus 2y into e to the power of minus y square plus y square. ये हमारा plus y square और ये minus y square. So this will be equal to 2y e to the power of 0. So e to the power of 0 is 1. So this will be equal to 2y. So our h1 of y is 2y. So solution हमारा यहाँ polynomial जो है for n is equal to 1, we get this particular polynomial. ये हमारा एक solution हुआ. तीन solutions हमें निकालने हैं. Second solution will be for b, that is n is equal to 2. उसी equation में हम n is equal to 2 करेंगे तो h2 of y हमें मिलेगा, that is minus 1 square e to the power of y square. Now d square by dy square e to the power of minus y square. So this will be minus 1 ka square plus 1. So that will be just 1. So it will be e to the power of y square. D square by dy square. Mein pehli baar jab hum differentiate karenge, so it will be d by dy of d by dy of e to the power of minus y square. So that will be minus 2y e to the power of minus y square. तो इसको हम वापस से हमें एक बार और differentiate करना पड़ेगा. So that will be ये e to the power of y square ऐसे ही रहेगा. Differentiate इसको करेंगे तो ये u into v term हो गया. Minus 2 हमारा constant है, बाहर आ जाएगा. And y into e to the power of minus y square. So y को हम पहले differentiate करते हैं तो 1 होगा. So minus e square minus y e to the power of minus y square रहेगा plus y into e to the power of minus y square को differentiate करेंगे तो that will be minus 2y into e to the power of minus y square. Sorry. E to the power of minus y square minus 2 into this e to the power of minus y square हमारा constant बाहर निकल जाएगा दोनों में. This will be 1 plus यहाँ पे minus 2 y square minus 2 y square. So this will be e to the power of y square minus और ये माइनस इनटू माइनस प्लस 4 y स्क्वायर e टू द पावर ऑफ y स्क्वायर. Into half, so ये भी हमारा into not minus 2 not plus, it will be into. This will be e to the power of y square और ये e to the power of minus y square हमारे cancel हो जाएंगे. We will have minus 2 plus 4 y square और it will be minus 2 into 1 minus 2 y square. Or we can write it as h2 of y is equal to 4y square minus 2. Yes, 4y square minus 2. This will be our h2 of y. Similarly, we can find it out for h3 of y. Can you do that for homework? H3 of y mein kya karna hai aapko? For n is equal to 3. You will get h3 of y equals minus 1 raised to 3 e to the power of y square into d cube by dy cube e to the power of minus y square. Teen bar differentiate karna hai e to the power of y minus y square. 3 times differentiate karoge to aapko ye aayega. Your answer will be, final answer should be h3 of y is equal to 8y square minus 12y. ये आपका फाइनल आंसर आना चाहिए. नहीं आता है तो लेट मी नो.